With ChatGPT, the field of generative AI has become very popular. Maybe you are wondering what generative AI actually is. Let me explain this field before diving into LangChain. You may have heard of deep learning. Generative AI is a subfield of deep learning and is used to generate new content such as text, images, music, audio, and video. We use LLMs such as GPT, Mistral, Llama to generate this content. That's great, right? Recently, it has become very popular to develop applications such as chatbot using LLMs. This is where LangChain comes into play. In short, LangChain is a framework for developing applications using LLMs. This framework was released in the last year, but it quickly became very popular. It's good news that a new stable version of LangChain, version 0.1, was recently released. So, what's in this stable version? Let's go over the important new features. Here is the new ecosystem of LangChain. In the previous version, all modules were in the LangChain library. With the new version, LangChain is divided into three main parts: LangChain Core, LangChain Community, and LangChain itself. LangChain Core contains basic functions, interfaces, and abstractions. This library is more stable than the other libraries. Let me say this, the previous version of LangChain will continue as LangChain. The version of this one will continue as 0.0.x. This library includes chain, agents, and retrieval strategies. There are third-party integrations in the LangChain community. Right now, there are more than 700 libraries in LangChain that work with LangChain. Here, you can see these third-party integrations. All the important packages related to generative AI are integrated with LangChain. It's cool! LangChain is at the center of all these packages. Also, as it is written here, 10 packages such as OpenAI, Google, and Mistral have separate libraries. For example, here is OpenAI's library linked to LangChain. In this documentation, you can see how to work with this library. We will use this library often. You can use LangSemit to debug your LangChain application. With this component, you can observe your errors step by step while developing your app. You can deploy your LLM applications with LangServe. With this component, you can preview your LLM applications on a playground. Yeah, these are the components of LangChain in summary. Although LangChain was recently launched, it has developed very fast and has become one of the most important libraries in generative AI. I think LangChain will develop further and become the center of generative AI applications. In the next videos, we will get our hands dirty with LangChain and build lots of applications. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and leave a comment. See you in the next video. Bye for now.